Jay Cutler and Kristin Cavallari. I guess you could put sum it up this way. What, 10 years of marriage? Everything was seemingly fine. And then a little over a month of quarantine, and they have now filed for divorce. Jay actually
that in
filed.
That in itself, by the way, is interesting, because we've talked about that, whether the divorce rate's going to go up when people are just stuck together.
And I would say that based on what we've seen now in their divorce documents, we broke the story this morning on the website, it does sound like they just had time together to talk about some things, and Kristin does not like what she heard. Because in her now Jay actually filed for divorce first. She responded a couple of days later and blasted him. I mean, she's accusing him, it seems, of cheating. The words that she actually uses
is marital misconduct. So what's interesting about this is that she first announced the divorce. It was interesting because even though Jay filed, I thought she filed because she put the statement out yesterday before we got the documents, and she talked about this being kind of a loving divorce. Well, at first we thought, okay, well, this is super amicable. Then we read her response, and it ain't super amicable. She is saying that he is not telling the truth in his documents when he says he's an involved parent. She comes close to saying he's an absentee parent. And she wants primary custody, which is always a sign of something, and wants to give him visitation. He wants joint custody. But these documents are really revealing. And she talks about that this is a threat to the family. And I believe she even, did she say physical threat, Charles? I forgot in the documents.
Is it the part, Harvey, where she said that he was guilty of such inappropriate marital conduct as renders for further cohabitation unsafe and improper? Is that the part you're talking about?
Yeah, I mean, I just think the words unsafe.
Unsafe is a strong word to use there.
And another interesting part about the petition, you guys, is she actually listed the date of separation as April 7th, which, if you remember, this is the day that they got back from their long vacation to the Bahamas. They actually got stuck out there because when they first went out, it was right when the pandemic was happening. So they got stuck out there for a while, and something must have happened on this trip for her to come home and be like, we're done.
Yeah, we don't know where they were when they came back. Did they not live together? Did they live together the way she makes it seem? Something happened there, and when they came back, they were not together. That's at least the way she makes it seem. But it's clearly...
I've got a question. What state did they file in? I know they live in Tennessee, but I'm just wondering where the primary home.
I got it right here. It was filed in, I think it was filed in Tennessee, Charles.
Hi, I'm Katie from Denver, Colorado. At first, it came out as Instaperfect on Instagram, the sad news they're divorcing. And now a day later, it looks like what happened in the Bahamas doesn't stay in the Bahamas, and let the divorce and the lawyers fly. I'm super sad.
Three kids. By the way, she's asking for child support too. So we will see.